Hi, I'm Captain Mike, and you're watching Florida Sport Fishing. We've got a really awesome episode in store for you today. We're backcountry fishing. We're going to fish some grass flats. I'm sure as the day progresses, we're going to hit up some docks as well. I'm here with Captain Carlos Rodriguez. You know, there's some really basic tips and tricks and techniques that you have to utilize when you're fishing inshore in order to find action. And these apply regardless if you're fishing down in Florida Bay, Biscayne Bay, over on the West Coast, or we're here today on the Indian River Lagoon. Just an absolutely awesome venue with a lot of different opportunities. So we're gonna go out there, we're fishing strictly artificial baits, and we wanna show you exactly what we look for when we're out here targeting trout, redfish, and snook. So stick around, let's see if we can get hooked up.
Ho ho, what on?
CB Boats presents Florida Sport Fishing, television for the avid angler. Powered by Mercury Marine.
Oh, there he is, right there.
Oh, awesome, dude, that was sick.
Oh, another one on.
Woo! Nice, that's what it's all about right there.
Yeah.
Oh, look at that.
The water is about 3 or 4 feet deep. We're fishing some paddle tail jigs and just reeling them nice and steady, little twitch every now and then, and you want to keep that jig right above the top of the grass. You want to kind of have it swimming through the grass. It looks like a little wounded mullet, little wounded bait fish.
I got one.
Got one?
Yeah, I got something. I don't know why, but something.
Nice, all right, good.
Yeah.
See, we're fishing, you got on top of grass and right away. Yep, got one.
Is that
another
a good
trout.
One?
Ah, just another little trout, but I mean, it just goes to show you, you know, we made a little move, got on top of some grass, and boom, within 2 seconds, we're both hooked up on trout. Nothing huge, but that's what we want right there. Little. Typical Indian River trout, just clobbered that shrimp. Again, you don't need any live bait. So colorful, little Indian River trout. It's the whole key when you're inshore looking for action. It's grass. The grass holds the grass shrimp, the grass holds the crabs, the tiny pinfish. It holds all of the life. And obviously if the bait's there, if the food's there.
Big blow up out there.
The fish are gonna be there.
Little speckles.
Don't know how long this bite's gonna last, so we've gotta stay right on it. Sometimes these fish will turn on, they'll turn off for no apparent reason. There you go, good job.
I might have a little more weight to
that's
it.
That's a little bit bigger, dude. Yeah. That's a nicer fish. Yes. Dude, that's a nice trout right there. Nothing huge, but that's certainly
look
bigger.
Look at the bait getting,
look at the bait getting crushed.
Yeah, he's chunky.
What'd you catch that one on?
Paddle tail?
Yeah.
Think he wanted that? Look at where that is. It's in his throat.
Florida Sport Fishing is proudly presented by Ghost, boat security, monitoring, and tracking you can count on. Mr. Ice Machines, your outlet for Manitowoc ice machines. Ballyhood Lures, jets, feathers, and chuggers sold rigged and ready to catch fish. P&R Canvas, custom marine canvas, manufacturing, design, and installation. Fishing Pursuits, visit fishingpursuits.com and go fish the planet. Are you ready to get hooked up? Florida Sport Fishing Magazine, your number one resource for the latest tips, tricks, tactics, and techniques for inshore and offshore. Only $30 for 3 years. For immediate home delivery, visit floridasportfishing.com. Enter promo code TV and receive a free shirt and official decal with paid subscription.
Hi, high-performance hulls designed for speed, comfort, and durability. Custom features and accessories designed for every taste. A brilliantly engineered machine designed to catch more fish. Presenting the remarkable lineup from CB Boats.
The secret's out. Start with brine and bite, the only brine that infuses proven bite stimulants into any rigged bait. Procure badass bait dyes are next, and bring Ballyhoo to life with vibrant fluorescent colors. Seal the deal with Procure's new Bloody Tuna Oil and watch your catch ratio soar. Inshore and offshore, Procure bait scents and badass bait dyes keep you hooked up. Find Procure at your favorite dealer or call 800-PROCURE for a free catalog.
Yachtlights.com, everything marine lighting, interior and exterior. Yachtlights.com has it all at the lowest prices. Stylish recessed lights, LED strips, floodlights and deck lights, and the hottest underwater lights from as low as $199. Shop online for free shipping and weekly clearance items, or visit our new showroom. When you need marine lighting, you need Yachtlights.com. Tired of outrageous markups? Stingray Fishing Outfitters beats all advertised prices with specials on the finest tournament-winning tackle, accessories, and outdoor apparel. Operated by knowledgeable anglers, with everything you need for freshwater and saltwater fishing under one roof, ready for immediate delivery. Save big. Shop where the pros shop. Shop at stingraytackle.com.
Jig moving, nice and steady, couple of twitches. Anybody can do this. It's really, you know, it's not that difficult. It's an awesome Indian River trout. It's cookie cutter fish. They're not huge, but fun, you know, fun on light tackle. You don't need heavy gear. 10-pound outfits, that's it. Paddle tail jigs, artificial shrimp, they'll hit it all. You get on top of these fish, you work the area really thoroughly, you can't go wrong. Get ready to release this guy. There we go. It's a beautiful fish, nice and colorful. You know, these trout in the wintertime are really, really active. They'll come up on these grass flats, they'll feed on grass shrimp, little pinfish. There we go. They'll pretty much feed on anything that they can, and get that jig out of your mouth. There you go. Great for kids. Or if you're just getting into inshore fishing, it's a great way to start the day. I'll tell you, these inshore bait scents, they work. You know, not to say that you're not going to catch fish without it, of course you will. But you can enhance your lure just a little bit more. Why not do it? Yeah, I'm going to get us back a little bit closer. Seems like right on that edge there.
I'm seeing a lot out here, man. Like way out here, see? They're busting all out there.
Oh, there's one right there, dude. I'm not kidding you, that added scent, dude. I was never a believer, started using it, and I saw a noticeable increase in the amount of strikes. So I figured, hey, why not? Why not do it? All right. Stay with us for our rigging station. I'm gonna give you a close look at the tackle that we're using today. It's obviously working.
See the fangs? Even on the little ones, they got fangs. Straight nastiness fangs.
Rigging Station, brought to you by Diamond Fishing Products, the most reliable monofilament and braided fishing line in the world.
Hi, and welcome to this episode's Rigging Station. We're here in the Indian River Lagoon, Jensen Beach, Florida, having a great day of backcountry fishing, and I wanted to talk to you a little bit more about the tackle that we're using today. You know, nothing fancy, 7 foot, 7.5 foot, Chaos composite rods. They're a combination of graphite and fiberglass for both sensitivity and strength. Really, really lightweight. You can fish with these outfits all day. You can, you know, cast 1,000 times and not get tired. Rods are rated for 8 to 17 pound test. We've got our Daiwa Coastal Reels, 3,000 and 4,000 series reels loaded with 10 pound diamond braid. Really, really important, ultra thin, very little stretch, and super, super sensitive. And that's what's important when you're fishing these really light artificial baits. Our leader system is really basic and really simple, nothing fancy. 3 feet of 20 pound diamond presentation fluorocarbon leader. It's tied to our braid with either a uni to uni or a simple surgeon's knot. And that's it. And then we've got our little jigs. We're fishing artificial shrimp. We're fishing paddle tail jigs, gold spoons, just tied to the leader with a small loop knot. And that allows that artificial bait maximum freedom, maximum movement in the water to really mimic a live prey item. You don't need anything else. You know, we've got our favorite jig heads and everywhere from a 16th of an ounce all the way on up to 1/8 ounce, a 1/4 ounce, you know, different sizes for different applications and different depths of water. A whole variety of artificial shrimp, either pre-rigged shrimp like the DOA favorites that are just killer, along with a variety of soft shrimp that we can rig on jig heads and fish any way we'd like. Our favorite paddle tail jigs in a variety of colors for different water conditions. Got a little bit of Procure Mullet Super Gel. I like to spice up my baits with a little bit of added flavor. Just that extra bit of enhancement certainly doesn't hurt. And often that triggers a strike when nothing else will. And that's it. You know, some favorite artificials, some light tackle spinning outfits. If you're not already cashing in on the hot fisheries in your area, in your neck of the woods, get out there, get yourself some light tackle, get out on the grass flats, fish some docks, do it right, and you'll get hooked up.
Rigging Station, brought to you by Diamond Fishing Products, the most reliable monofilament and braided fishing line in the world. Florida Sport Fishing is proudly presented by Sea Sucker. Mount anything, anywhere, with no tools and no holes. Saltwater Assassin Lures, soft plastic go-to baits for every fish in every venue. New Ice, maximize cooler performance with New Ice eco-friendly freezer packs. Skeleton Fish, wearable art. Select your trophy and receive free shipping at skeletonfish.com. Crystal Reels, power and versatility, setting the standard with all-in-one electric fishing reels.
Chaos is tragic. Chaos can be awesome.
Yo, another one on, another one on! Three on, baby!
With Chaos Fishing, it's your rod your way. Quality components and personalized service from a legendary builder equal the right rod at the right price every time. Shop online for a complete selection of serious fishing equipment. Or visit Chaos's new superstore and receive a free t-shirt with every rod purchase. Chaos Fishing, gear matters.
What if navigating was as simple as touch and go? It is that simple. The world's first multi-touch MFT chart plotter, Navnet TZ Touch.
Scent Blazer is changing fishing forever. This revolutionary new trolling lure looks, sounds, smells, tastes, and swims like a real fish. The advantage is in the patented detachable bait chamber, loaded with bait weights, lights, rattles, and more. As it's trolled, water enters the lure and passes over the bait inside, leaving a trail of scent and bait pieces behind. Get more strikes, get more fish, get Scent Blazer. For more information and to find your nearest retailer, visit scentblazer.com.
100, 500, 1,000. How much money are you wasting on melted ice and thawed bait? Frigid Rigid keeps ice and bait frozen for 10 days. Built to withstand everyday use, 25 sizes up to 525 quarts means there's a Frigid Rigid cooler, refrigerator, or tackle center just for you. The boat may have burnt down, but the ice and chum stayed frozen. Frigid Rigid, 800-643-1988, or visit frigidrigid.com for a dealer near you.
Fish are just cruising around this grass. You can see with that pattern, see that dark pattern on their back, that olive green with the little dark spots, they just perfectly camouflage into the bottom, into the grass. And the bait never sees them coming. Look at that, it will just sink right, boom, gone. You don't even see that fish anymore, and he's just laying just a couple of feet below the surface. The trout fishing, you know, fortunately, is something you can really rely on. You can always come out here and catch a handful of trout. Get the hook out of them. There we go. We got a couple of fangs right up on top, little teeth. Nice olive back there. It's certainly not a huge fish, but again, a lot of fun on light tackle. And it, you know, just proves the point that if you find the grass, if you find where these fish are feeding, you're gonna catch them. Just take your time, you know, try some different stuff. We're fishing paddle tail jigs, some imitation shrimp, and it's working. Gosh, I don't know, that's probably, what number is that, 40? Okay, maybe I was exaggerating a little. 20. There we go, another one of these trout. You know, the cool thing about these fish, it's just proof that spending the extra time to do your homework, to key in on these areas, and find the spots that are likely gonna hold fish, when you start catching trout, it's rewarding. It means you're doing your homework right. Great way to fine-tune your tactics, and again, it just proves that if you focus your efforts in the right areas, you're gonna catch them. See if we can catch a couple more, and then we're gonna go try a couple other grass flats, some areas that we've never fished before. See if we can find some larger redfish there.
Pro's Tip, brought to you by Pelagic, high performance offshore gear.
On this episode, you heard me talk a lot about locating and keying in on likely areas that hold bait and the game fish that we're looking for. Here's how we find them. Most importantly, nothing beats local knowledge. Regardless of your experience level, anglers can't master every waterway. Florida's inshore lagoons, rivers, and backcountry bays are simply too vast with an incredible amount of fishy water. I start by talking to guides, bait shops, and other fishermen familiar with that particular area. Forums and online fishing reports are also a great place to gather intel. Most importantly, I use online satellite imagery. By zooming into Google Map or Google Earth images, I can find grass beds, current swept points, docks covered by boathouses coupled with deep troughs. I can clearly see channel edges, distinct drop-offs, spoil islands. It's all right here at my fingertips, well before I ever leave the dock. From there, I cross-reference with my Navionics app on my mobile device, and I can confirm depth of water. I can find and investigate the nearest boat ramps. And because all of this information is portable, I can do my homework at any time and from anywhere. With rising fuel costs and free time more precious than ever, it really just makes good sense to have a solid game plan in mind long before you ever hit the water.
Pro's Tip, brought to you by Pelagic, high performance offshore gear.
Think about fishing these docks. You really have to approach them really, really quietly. You know, these fish will spook from hull slap. They'll spook from the noise from the electric trolling motor cavitating. So you really want to approach the dock really, really quietly. Got some bait in here. You see some little mullet flickering, jumping.
That makes a big difference.
Yep. I mean, the food's here, the conditions are right. When you're fishing that gold spoon, Carlos, are you just wiggling that thing right over the grass, right at the top of the...
I change it up. Sometimes I'll do a steady retrieve, so it stays right above the grass. Other times I'll cast it out, let it hit the bottom, just stop and go. You know?
You don't have to move it fast, right? No. I mean, it's just supposed to mimic a crab or, you know, a shrimp or...
Sometimes I reel it pretty fast and they still pounce on it. It depends how aggressive they are.
Mm-hmm. You know? That's the thing about fishing during the winter, spring, or late fall, you know, when it's chilly out. You don't have to get out here at the crack of dawn. Give that sun a chance to warm the water a bit. Keep in mind that dark flats are generally going to be a little bit warmer, will retain a little bit more heat than lighter sandy flats. The key is really just to be thorough. Keep casting. You know, when you're fishing artificial baits and you're fishing inshore, you better plan on making 1,000 casts that day.
Felt like a good hit too, finally.
Did it?
Yeah.
Let me see if I can catch him.
Hey, go ahead, do that. I want you to do that. See if you can do that.
Nice redfish, dude.
Is that
nice,
a donkey?
Nice red.
It's a donkey.
Just being persistent, working this whole bank, throwing little paddle tail jigs. And picked off a nice redfish. They're so cool.
He's got a little shoulder on him. That's a healthy one.
Yeah, it's not huge, but.
Yeah.
There we go. He doesn't want to give up. Doesn't want to give up. Really cool black spot on him right there. Really healthy, colorful. Come on. There we go. What a, such a cool fish. Little Indian River red. Just a little paddle tail jig, nothing super fancy. Dude, that's a nice fish. Nothing the matter with that. Get yourself some of that right there. Let's let him go.
See that spoon close enough?
I certainly did. So it will go right by my face.
Right in front of his face. I give him a bird's eye view.
Florida Sport Fishing is proudly presented by Daiwa Reels, advancing the sport of fishing. Tropic Trailer, Florida's largest dealer, has the right trailer at the right price. Rodan, precision GPS guided trolling motors. Fortress Marine Anchors, stronger, faster, lighter. Closed captioning provided by Boat Insurance Florida. Save 50%.
Bionic Bait is the largest ballyhoo producer in the world, serving anglers for 25 years. We offer 100 varieties of bait for every type of saltwater fishing. Bionic ballyhoo are exclusively caught and brined aboard our own boats in the Florida Keys. Within 24 hours, they're vacuum packed, flash frozen, and shipped in our own fleet of freezer trucks. Dedicated to excellent customer service, no one works harder to ensure your baits produce. Whether you're after a fresh fish dinner or a tournament-winning marlin, fish prefer Bionic Bait.
Right now we're burning about 8.5. I can't do this on my yamis.
We're burning about 27.3 an hour. For full throttle, it's extremely impressive.
Burning 29 gallons an hour, I'd be burning close to 40 with my Yamahas. Dude, I'm speechless.
To discover the Verado difference, find a local dealer at mercurymarine.com/Verado. Then take a test drive and experience it for yourself.
It's unbelievable.
Boy, yeah, that's a good 5 feet. That's the caveman depth finder right there. That's what that is. Nada. There we go. Come on.
Got him?
Yeah.
Nice. There you go again. Focused. No, that's a little bit bigger. That's certainly bigger, dude. On the spoon?
On the spoon.
There we go. Got another trout, dude. Clobbered that shrimp right there. Just a little soft shrimp on a jig head. Nothing fancy. That thing just crushed it. Gobbled it right up. Just let it hit the bottom and just twitching it, bouncing it. Make sure it hits the bottom. Just like a shrimp would do. And this is really key. This is where the ultralight tackle comes into play, the little 10-pound test, because you could feel every little nook and cranny, every little bump. It's a decent one, chunky. Get this guy up. There we go. Tell you what, fishing the grass flats has certainly been productive today. Let's go ahead and let this guy go. Another little trout here. Pretty much wraps up another episode of Florida Sport Fishing here. We've had a really, really awesome day on the grass flats. Caught a ton of trout, fished the docks, caught a nice redfish. And just wanted to remind you of some of the tips to look for in your area. Moving water is an absolute necessity. You've got to have some current. You know, regardless if it's incoming tide, outgoing tide, that water's got to be moving. Look for those really rich, thick grass beds. They're going to hold the shrimp, they're going to hold the minnows, and those are going to be the areas where you're going to catch the fish. We fished just a bunch of artificials today, little paddle tail jigs and imitation shrimp. Nothing fancy, but you got to cast. You got to cast all day and keep that bait working all day long. So hopefully you picked up a couple of great tips. We're out of here. We'll see you next week. Oh, I missed one. Oh, I got a nibble. Oh, I got a bite.
You can't copy me.
Dude, you've had 411 bites.
10,000 nibbles. Oh, there was a bump. Oh, hey. Somebody's down there peeking. Oh, I think I just got a nibble. Ah, I got it. That was a fish. Oh, that was a bite. Oh,
you are one of a kind.
I am.
You can be, yeah, you can be imitated, but not duplicated.
I'm the originator. He's just jealous.
I am jealous. I am jealous. Okay. Dude, if you've had that many bites, I'm freaking jealous.
Yeah, look. See? You want me to show you? See the scars on the hook?
The scars on the hook.
Yeah. Like little.
To learn more about the tactics and techniques seen on today's show, and to subscribe to Florida Sport Fishing Magazine, visit floridasportfishing.com and get hooked up.